just can't get her out of my mind. And when I sleep, I visualize her. I saw her in the pub. I met her later at the nightclub. A mutual friend introduced us. We talked about the noise and how it's hard to hear your own voice above the beat and the sub bass. We talked and talked for hours. We talked in the back of our friend's car as we all went back to his place. She told me that she really liked me, and I said, cool, the feeling's mutual. We played old 45s. I said, it's like the soundtrack to our lives. And she said, true, it's not unusual. Then privately we danced, but couldn't seem to keep our balance. A drunken haze had come upon us. We sank down to the floor and we sang, the sun ain't gonna shine anymore. And then we kissed and fell unconscious. I woke up the next day, all alone but for a headache. I stumbled out to find the bathroom, but all I found was her wrapped around another lover. No longer then is he our mutual friend?
Bonjour, mes amis. You can stop clapping now. Tonight we fly over the houses, the streets and the trees, over the dogs down below. They'll bark at our shadows as we float by on the breeze. Tonight we fly over the chimney tops, skylights and slates, looking into all your lives and wondering why happiness is so hard to find. Over the doctor, over the soldier, over the farmer, over the poacher, over the preacher, over the gambler, over the teacher, over the writer, over the lawyer, over the dancer, over the warrior, over the builder and the destroyer, over the hills and far away. Tonight we fly over the mountains, the beach and the sea, over the friends that we've known and those that we now know and those whom we'll get to. Disappointed or sad, if heaven doesn't exist, what will we have missed? This life is the best we've ever had.
Merci. Ça va? Oui, ça va bien, merci. Hello, up there. Hello, down there. And hello, around there. Okay, put the lights down, Jeff. It's freaking me out. Beaucoup de people. This is one from the last album.
Smoking my 600th last cigarette out of the studio skylight, watching the ash as it rolls down the roof, leaving a trail of gray white. All through its short life, it gives of itself, giving, and slowly diminishing until there isn't
negative. I'm not drunk yet. Yet. How I write songs. Thank you. Et maintenant, une chanson à propos de l'amour. Have you ever started dancing in the middle of a shopping mall? And have you ever burst out laughing for no reason at all? Have you ever noticed the rhythms in the rain? And have you ever felt the ecstasy? Have you ever been in love? Have you ever sung along to all the silly love songs you hate? And have you had to pinch yourself to make sure you're into the sky, like the laws of physics simply don't apply? Have you ever been in love? Have you ever been in love? been in love. Took your daddy's car, drove it to the sea, fooled around for hours, and then when we got tired and it got dark, we found a place to park, and we watched the sun set fire. Thanks very much. Well, I'm having a good time. Maintenant, une chanson à propos de la France. Thank you. twilight turns from amethyst to deep and deeper blue. We've got an hour or two before it's time to go. Let's go see a movie show. Jean can...
Bollocks.
Jean can choose between the two, 'cause Jules is hip and Jim is cool, and so they live together with the trees and birds and little girls who play upon poor Jean-Claude's nerves, till finally he strokes Claire's knee. And when she asks of his ambition, Jean-Pierre replies, my mission is to become eternal and to heaven knows the reason why. When the lights go out all over Europe, I forget about old Hollywood, 'cause Doris Day could never make me cheer up quite the way those French girls always could. When the lights go out all over Europe, I forget about old MGM, 'cause Paramount was never Universal, and Warner's went out way back when. Those lights go out all over Europe, I forget about old Hollywood, 'cause Doris Day could never cheer up quite the way those French girls always go. I'd sleep in the day, if you were the day. I'd cry in the night, 'cause you are the way, the truth and the light. If you were a tree, I could put my arms around you, and you would not complain. I could carve my name into your side, and you would not cry, 'cause trees don't cry. I would still love you if you were a drink. I'd drink my fill of you if you were attacked. I would kill for you if your name was Jack. I'd change mine to Jill for you if you were a horse. I'd clean the crap out of your stable and never once complain. If you were my little girl, I would find it hard to let you go. If you were my sister, I would find it doubly so. Straps from off the table, though my wife complains. If you were my dog, I am sure you'd like it better than you'd be my loyal four-legged friend. You'd never have to think again, and we could be together till the just in case. Jeff, a little more light. I want to see them from this angle. There you go. That's enough. yeah, not too much. I'm only joking. God, I sounded really Northern Irish there. I'm only joking. Hey. You're all thinking, it sounds exactly the same to me. okay. Postcards and letters, T-shirts and sweaters, passports and parkas, mobiles and chargers, two tennis rackets, blue Rizla packets, my new sheepskin jacket, I lost it all through my life. There have been many rains. to call mine, but I just cannot seem to keep hold of anything for more than a short time. Possessions are a sentimental kind. They were mine, now they're not. Lost, blown like seeds on the tossed like ships on the ocean and dashed on the rocks, hiding just out of reach, waiting for is to know just where do those lost things go when they slip from my hand. And then one night in a dream I pass through the sheepskin screen to to the sky, and I cry tears of joy. Once there was a time when my mind lay on higher things, and once there was a time I could find pretty words to sing. But now, well now I find it saves time to say what you mean. I know it seems so unrefined, but it's time to let off some steam. Oh, come on, everybody knows that no means yes, just like classes come free on the NHS. But the more I look through them, the more I see I'm becoming more like Alfie. I forgot to wear my glasses. It's very important that I wear my Alfie glasses. Once there was a time when a kind word could be enough. Yeah, once there was a time I could blindfold myself with love. But not now, for now I'm resigned to the kind of life I had reserved for the other guys, the less smart than I. Oh, you know, the kind who will always end up with the girls. And besides, everybody knows that no means yes. Just like classes come free on the NHS. But the more I look through them, the more I see I'm becoming more like Alfie. Oh, come on. The more I look, the more every day I'm becoming more like Alfie. Poor people down here, I've just realized you can't see me. There I am. Thank God. I guess I'll take these off now. Vision. Okay, where am I? Oh, yeah. Gosh, it's hot outside today. Anybody get sunburnt? Heat stroke? This is a song about how I hate the fucking summer.
Celebrating life, and so should we.
such a lovely day. When sunshine comes your way, it's time to make some hay. Tricky solo time. When it's hot and everybody smiles, I just can't help myself, I'm in love with the summer time. Even when I get hay fever, I find achoo! But I don't really mind as long as I'm in love with the summer time. Merci. We go down to the indie disco every Thursday night. Dance to our favorite indie hits until the morning light. At the indie disco. Table in the corner that is always ours. Under the poster of Morrissey with a bunch of flowers. Oh. We drink and talk about stupid stuff, then hit the floor for tainted love. You know I just can't get enough of the indie. Give us some pixies and some roses and some valentines, and we're in heaven. Give us some Blur and some Cure and some wanna dies. We'll dance forever. And now we're moving to the beat and staring at each other's feet. I wonder if she fancies me. It's over and I'm freezing on the night bus home. I think of her and I sing the words to my favorite song. Oh yeah. That could either be a reference to Ash, oh yeah, or Roxy Music, oh yeah. Very good song. Anyway, moving on. She makes my heart beat the same way as at the start of Blue Monday. Anyway, always the last song that they play at the indie disco. The indie disco. Ah, excellent, merci. Actually, I'm moving this one up the set list because it's quite relevant to that last song. Shit, right. Make some music, make some money, make some models for wives. I'll move to Paris, smoke some heroin and fuck with the stars. You'll have the island and the cocaine and the elegant cars. This is our decision to live fast and die young. We've got the vision, now let's have some fun. Yeah, it's overrated, but what else can we do? Get jobs in offices and wake up. Choke on our vomit, and that will be the end. We're fated to pretend, to pretend. We're fated to pretend, to pretend. I said, yeah, yeah. Has now become torrential and doesn't look like coming to an end. The two bedraggled figures that huddle in the doorway with nothing vaguely waterproof to wear are now secretly wishing they'd listen to their mothers when being told to always be prepared. Screaming Geronimo, they run for it down the road with an arm around her waist. He leads her to a place he knows. Soaked through but happy, they squelch up to the landing. The room before them makes a welcome sight. The coal fire is throwing strange shapes upon the hearthrug and crying out to be knelt down beside. She pulls off her jumper and flings it in the corner. He picks it up and hangs it on a chair. She puts on a record and sings into her coffee. He puts a blanket around her, sits her down and dries her beautiful hair. I'm warning you, I will get this wrong. There's 1,000 chords in this fucking song, but we'll have some fun while I get it wrong.
Race by
suppose they think that we're in love. Well, I think they might be right. And without warning, when we're almost at the top, the wheel that turns us all comes to a sudden stop. The wind that's blown us dies a quick and painless death. The air gets clammy and we hold each other's breath. We get the feeling that we're not alone in this, and that a God who really ought not to exist sticks out a great big hand and grabs me by the wrist and asks me why, and I say, well, God, it's like this. It might be arrogance or just appalling taste. I'd rather use my pain than let it all go to waste on some old God who tells me what I want to hear, as if I cannot tell obedience from fear. I want to take my pleasures where and how I will, be they disgraceful or distasteful or distilled. And to be frank, I find that life has more appeal without a driver who's asleep behind the wheel. Then God decides that he has taken quite enough of all this atheistic tosh I'm spouting off, and so he calls upon his favorite angel choir to sing of times when men were filled with Christian fire. But overzealous angels flap their wings too fast and cause the wind to blow, turn the wheel at last, and soon my feet are safely back on solid ground. And then I hear a voice say, don't look down. Merci. Reminds you of the old days. Except Joby always used to get the chords wrong. Come on, you fucking machine. Do it by ear. I hadn't got it turned on. Right, now, okay, excuse me. Yeah, do something funny with the lights, Jeff. Again. Oh, sweet home. The only French I know is from Jacques Brel songs. Excuse me? Who's doing the show here? No. She's quite right. In fact, she's probably from my distributors. Back in the day you had been part of the smart set. You'd holidayed with kings, dined out with starlets. From London to New York, Cap Ferrat to Capri. In perfume by Chanel and clothes by Givenchy. You sipped Camparis with David and Peter at Noel's parties by Lake Geneva, stealing the cologne from high society, armed only with a checkbook and a family tree. You chased the sun around a cold azure until the light of youth became obscure and left you on your own and in the shade, an English English lady of a certain age. And if a nice young man would buy you a drink, you'd say with a conspiratorial wink, you wouldn't think that I was 63. And he'd say, no, you couldn't be. You had to marry someone very, very rich so that you might be kept in the style to which you had all of your life been accustomed to. But that the socialists had taxed away from you. You gave him children, a girl and a boy. To keep your sanity, a nanny was employed. And when the time came, they were sent away. Well, that was simply what you did in those days. You chase the sun around the Côte d'Azur until the light of youth became obscured and left you on your own and in the shade. An English lady of a certain age. And if a nice young man would buy you a drink, you'd say with a conspiratorial wink, you wouldn't think that I was 53. And he'd say, no, you couldn't be. Your son's in stocks and bonds and lives back in Surrey, flies down once in a while and leaves in a hurry. Your daughter never finished her finishing school, married a strange young man of whom you don't approve. Your husband's hollow heart gave out one Christmas day. He left the villa to his mistress in Marseille. And so you come here to escape your little flat, hoping someone will fill your glass and let you chat about how you chase the sun around the Côte d'Azur until the light of youth became obscured and left you all alone and in the shade. An English lady of a certain age. And if a nice young man would buy you a drink, you'd say with a conspiratorial wink, you wouldn't think that I was 43. And he'd say, no, you couldn't be. Merci. That was a song called A Lady of Uncertain Age. Because I got all the ages wrong in the song. But it doesn't matter, because she doesn't know how old she is anyways. Oh, forget it. This is a song. This is a song about when I was young and imbecilic. Pale pubescent beasts roam through the streets and coffee shops. Their prey gather in herds of stiff knee-length skirts and white ankle socks. But while they search for a mate, might gun, uniform minds and uniform lines and uniform ties. Run round with trousers on fire and signs of desire they cannot disguise. While I try to find words as light as the birds that circle above, to put in my songs of love. Fate doesn't hang on a wrong or right choice. Fortune depends on the tone of your voice. So sing while you have time, let the sun shine down from above and fill you with songs of love. I'm going to whistle. No, fuck. What sort of a key is that? Yeah, you do it. Nice. Like Bridge Over the River Kwai. I can't whistle for shit. Very good. Merci. Fate doesn't hang on a wrong or right choice. Fortune depends on the tone of your voice. So let's sing while we still can, while the sun hangs high up above. Wonderful songs of love. Yeah, I heard you. Overstrand. You know, if I was made to play that song right now, and if I couldn't play it, I would be ritually slaughtered from, killed. Mort. I couldn't do it. I'd die. Because I can't remember even writing that song. So, sorry. Désolé. No, I'm going to stick to the menu. I packed up my suitcase and left the old farm. I promised my papa I'd come to no harm. And I went to the city where I was employed in a firm of accountants as an office boy. I fetched and I carried, I watched and I learned. And slowly but surely I rose through the firm until I discovered my colleagues one day, massaging the figures for personal gain. I said, I'll not wallow in this house of shame. I'll plow my own furrow, I'll go my own way. Gravely I listened to Reverend McBride down at the Mission House each Friday night. Heaven's salvation for those who know best, hell and damnation for all of the rest. Try as I might, I could not understand why the Almighty's all-merciful hand should cast away those whose only mistake was never to know the Christian faith. The stars that we follow will lead us astray. I'll plow my own furrow, I'll go my own way. I fled the city's consumer malaise, and I trekked through the wilderness for 14 days, till I found the guerrillas camped high in the hills. I asked Comrade Diaz whom I should kill. I crept into town with a knife in my teeth, and I entered the home of the chief of police. I stood at his bedside and I raised up my blade, but then I looked to the crib where his little one lay. You murder tomorrow by killing today. When a child cries, the tears rise quickly, spill hot and prickly down the reddened cheeks. And are gone as swiftly as they came, and peace returns again. When a child cries, you know about it, they scream and shout until the hurt is gone. Like a shower of rain that for a moment hides away the sun. But when a man cries, it's choked and throttled, it's all being bottled up for far too long. When at last the pressure cooker blows, it's hard to stem the flow. When a man cries, his body shakes and his mind vibrates and his eyeballs ache, but it doesn't make a sound. Don't want to wake the house now. Well, the reasons are vague, hard to put in words. Just a dull abstract ache. Don't want to worry her. She would only ask what's wrong, and I try to say that you take all my pain and explain it away. But who can explain why a man cries? When a man cries, he cries alone, and for just a moment he's back at home, cradled in his mother's arms, free from guilt and safe from harm. Everybody knows that I love you. Everybody knows that I need you. Everybody knows that I do, except you. I told the stars above about the one I love. I told the morning sun. Yeah, I'm telling everyone. I told my mom and dad, they seem to understand. I'll get through to you if it's the last thing that I do. Except you. Everybody knows I live for you. Everybody knows I adore you. Everybody knows that it's true. Except you. I told this, you put me off. I told them, what the hell is it? I told all of my friends again and again and again. I drove them round the bend. So now you're my only friends. I told the passers-by, I made a small boy cry. And I'll get through to you if it's the last thing that I do. 'Cause everybody knows that I love you. Everybody knows that I need you. Everybody knows that I do, except you. Yeah. except you. Well, everybody knows I live for you. Everybody knows I adore you. Everybody knows that it's true except you. Except you. I've got to say thank you very, very much. Merci tout le monde. Beaucoup. This is the last one. You sing when you're bathing. I like your dog when he's behaving. I like your car. You curse like a trooper during a hard reversing maneuver. I like the way we kiss and we make up after a fight. I like you 'cause you're sexy. I like the sexy things you dress in. I like it when you're sitting next to me, texting me sexy things. I like you 'cause you like me. I like the poems that you write me. I like the pictures that you thoughtfully draw for me. They make me look alright. Oh yeah. I like the way you do whatever you like. It comes Et maintenant, une chanson à propos de la crise financière. Greedy bastards. Can anyone lend me 10 billion quid? Why do you look so glum? Was it something I did? So I caused a second Great Depression. What can I say? I guess I got a bit carried away. If I say I'm sorry, will you give me the money? Well, that's just me, the complete banker in a black Bentley. Sweet Samantha riding next to me. Oh, how I hanker for the good old days when I was free, the complete banker in my Armani, before the rancor and disharmony. Well, money makes the world go round and round and down the drain. To war on the floor of the exchange. To all of us, it was just a big game. But God, I loved it, making a profit from somebody's loss. I never knew exactly whose money it was, and I did not care. As long as there was lots for me, the complete banker in a black Bentley, sweet Samantha riding next to me. Oh, how I hanker for the good old days when I was free, the complete banker in my Armani, before the anger and the inquiries. Well, money makes the world go round. Bankers can't play the piano, obviously. We'll learn the lessons, run tests and analyze. We'll crunch the numbers, 'cause the numbers never lie. Well, maybe this recession is a blessing in disguise. We can build a much, much bigger bubble the next time and leave the rest to clean our mess up. I'm very angry. That's just me, the complete banker in a black Bentley. Margaret Thatcher riding next to me. Oh, how I hanker for the good old. Society, and one day you'll let your guard down, and I'll come round again. I'll be back again, 'cause money makes the world go round and round and down the drain. Do you want to know what's inside my bag? Yeah. It's a big... Yeah, it's awful. Yeah. Sorry for the swearing. It's a big white envelope full of money. Madame Bettencourt is backstage. Boarding pass back to Dublin? I didn't prepare this, I'm just doing it. Muriel Spark, Prime of Miss Jean Brody, very good. Nintendo DS. Pipe. Inhaler. And lots of old tissues. Yeah, great. Okay. So now you know what a pop star has in his bag. Okay, I've really got to stop now. No, I can't go on all bloody night. My throat's getting sore, and the people of Spain need me. Am I going to start a sort of anti-Spanish riot or something? Fuck the Spanish. Anyway, here's another song. It could be any song right now, couldn't it? C'est une chanson à propos des bus. Take the National Express when your life's in a mess. It'll make you smile. All human life is here, from the feeble old dear to the screaming child. Student who knows that to have one of those would be suicide, yeah. To the family man, manhandling the pram with paternal pride. And everybody sings, ba 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 da ba. Just sit there feeling stressed. Take a little trip on the National Express. I am speechless. Honestly, merci tout le monde. No, stop being so nice. I don't know what to do with it, all this positivity. Okay. Just for that, you're getting the silliest song I have ever written. Can you stand upon one leg? It's harder than you think. If you can do it without falling down, you can do just about anything. Go on, give it a try. See how long you can stand on one leg. Can you, what's the next verse? Oh, that's right, yeah, thanks. Can you beat your dad at chess? It's harder than you think. Sit him down at Christmas, turn the TV off, give him lots of chocolates and a drink. And he might give you a match. And when you've been duly dispatched, he will laugh. Say one more game. Can you write a silly song? One that make no. Can you write a silly song? Oh, I'm really screwing up here. It's harder than you think, honestly. One that's not too short, one that's not too long, one that can make everybody sing. Go on, give it a try. Just like trying to stand on one leg. Tell me, can you tell a funny joke? One that makes you laugh out loud. One that makes the milk come out your nose. If you know a funny joke, then tell it now. Do we have a comedian? Yes, we do.
Supposed to say something really, really long, but Neil, do you know what is a canith? C'est un petit chien.
That's not bad. I'm impressed. But there's one final test. Can you hold a singing note for a stupidly long time? It's my party piece, so let's make it a little harder by starting it way up high. Come on, give it a go, try. No, go. Oh God, I'm so confused. Let's see how long you can. You've been great. Audience, merci Paris, merci France, bienvenue. Bonne nuit. Merci, au revoir.